So this is an example where I sort of need to, close the light. This is where I don't want light from there because I want all the light coming underneath. So it'll be okay. When I sort of get right in close to that, I can see quite a lot of information. So it's going to be fine. And this is nice. It's going to be, it's going to be straight onto one clean sheet of paper now. It's going to be terrific. Now, after I finish the ink work, you can imagine, then I would put it into Photoshop. And of course, I can change things in Photoshop. So I don't need to make this perfect. But I think it's always good to get as much. If I'm using a combination of hand drawing, oh sorry, it's all hand drawing, isn't it? Drawing on paper and using the computer. If I'm doing a combination, it's always good to get it as good as possible on paper. So I'm trying to be accurate and clean. But if I do make a mistake, I can, if I make a mistake drawing his face now, I can just draw another face on another sheet and just like I did before with those sketches, just patch it in. So it's not a problem. Beautiful. And now I'm going to start inking. And I'll start in the top left, just so that I'm not sort of interrupting. I mean, I'd probably like to start on his face first, but because he's sort of in the middle, I'll start up here. Now I'm just going to have a scrap piece of this ready because it's the same paper, so it's just going to help me sort of practice, warm up a bit. I'm just practicing here. I'm sort of going through two layers. Just as part of the practice. And I'm inking using this ink here and this pen. Because it's fun. All right, so that's what I'm doing. Thank you.
Thank you.
And the famous cigarette butt. Very important character in our story.
Thank you.
So I made a mistake here. I don't know if anyone will notice it, but it's a mistake. I might fix it in Photoshop. It's small, but it's a bit of a problem. Thank you. Oh, that's the mirror, Shane. Don't do that.
So I'm just opening my screen, my window here to get more light in. And I'm just gonna hold it up above now, okay? Now you won't be able to see this clearly, but I'm basically holding it above, trying to get it nice and flat. And as close as possible, so it's fairly large in the frame, because I want as much detail as I can. To check that it looks square. Let's take a few. Make sure. And then if I play those back, and then check on one. Then check. So it's pretty sharp. You won't be able to see very well in the photo, but it looks sharp to me. So I'll take this now and I'll send it to myself using, in the Mac, you've got this one called Share. then I can sort of airdrop it to myself. And when I do that, my computer becomes visible. And it's going to send that photo to my computer. I'm going to share that screen there. And then when I do yes, I'm going to the bottom of the screen wasn't visible, so now you can see the bottom. So down here on the bottom, in the bottom right, if I click the circle and add a curves, I'm adding a curves adjustment layer. And what that does in Photoshop is it adds a layer and it adds a tool. And the tool here is that curves tool I was talking about earlier. So if I grab the curve line, I can adjust either the shadow areas or the paper color. I sort of pull it down, it actually brightens the paper. And if I pull this, this is the shadow end. If I pull that up a bit, I'm going to darken the shadows. So I'm just trying to control the blacks and whites, you could say. The other way to do it is you can reset that, or you can try auto. That's one way to try it. So what auto's done is it's dragged the bottom right, bottom left edge in, so it's darker. But if I pull that back, see how it's making the blacks blacker. Just do the auto again. That's done a really good job, actually. And if I wanted to brighten up the whites, I could click on here, this little hand, and then I can click and drag on the white areas. And that's going to try to brighten the white areas. See that? Or darken. So I might just do that for a little bit. That's pretty good. So then I can look at before and after by clicking over here. Turn that eye off. That's before. And on, that's after. I think it's better. And it looks pretty good. So I'll just close that. And I'll save it. File, save. And it's already got a file name, but I can put it in a certain place now. So I would just probably put this on my desktop temporarily, but I'll put it somewhere safer. I'll just call it scans. So it's in this folder called scans. All right, now, if I wanted to add tone to this, I would do that on a separate layer. So let me show you now how I might add tone and also how I might add some lines. I could draw some lines for the boxes, for example. I could do that with the computer. Or I could do it on the drawing itself. There's different ways to do it, right? But the main thing is now, because I've got these I'm happy with, I'm going to select both these layers. I'm just going to right-click and merge layers. And that's just going to put it back to one layer. And then I'm going to unlock that by clicking on the padlock. On top now, I'm going to add a new layer. Okay, and I'm just going to call this tone. And the advantage of working on a separate layer is that it's what we call non-destructive. So if I get now a brush and I mix a color, in this case, a grey colour. If I paint it on there, you can see the paint going on, and it's covering up the other drawing. But in fact, it's on a separate layer, so I can always turn it off. And I can even do something fancy, which is where you can blend it. So I can blend this by multiplying it. And what now it's doing is it's sort of mixing the gray with the black and the gray with the white. So that's layer turned off and turned on. If I go back to normal, you can see it's actually hiding what's underneath. So this is one way to use Photoshop, okay? The main way is to keep everything on separate layers so you can control it. In fact, what I'll do is I'm going to copy the base layer just in case I make a mistake. And down here, I'm just going to turn it off so that it's kept safe. I'll just get rid of that tone layer for now. All right, so let's call this line work. Okay, add a new layer as I did before. Click down here on the plus sign, and I'll call that by double clicking here, tone. Now, at any time, I can move these layers around. Again, I'll do a quick example. I've got this tone here. I can put that behind the line work. So it's behind the line work. And then if I blend or multiply the line work, I'll see the tone through it. It's just coming from underneath this time. All right, so I'll undo that by going to File, Edit. Where is the undo function? I'm so used to doing the shortcut. It appears to be, oh yeah, it's the first one. There we go. Control Z or Command Z. But I normally just use the shortcuts, which is the Command key and the Z key. So I'm just undoing a few steps. Okay. Now the tone is here. So if I'm working in black and white, then I can leave this in as a grayscale image, as I showed you earlier. Okay, but if I wanted to, I could convert it back to color. It's going to look the same, but now I would have access to colors. So if I wanted to add color, I can now use color. Okay, and you can still play with these blending modes as I was showing you, but it's a quick way to access color is just to convert the file back to a color file. All right, Command Z to undo. I'm going to leave it as a grayscale file for now. And what I want to do is show you a quick way to add tone. So you could add tones with a brush. That's over here on the left, we've got a brush. You can see if I click on that, brings up the brush tool. And up here, you can control the size and the kind of effect or the flow. And that's a white brush. This is where the colors are. It's currently white. I could make it gray. I could make it dark gray. And I could make it black. All right, so these are all the things that I can play with. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a nice medium tone. And I'll be able to change it later if I'm not happy. But just so I can work with something, I'll pick a medium tone or a light tone. And I'm going to zoom in and just show you how easy it is to add color or to add tone. So I'm going to hit B for brush or click the brush icon. And if I pick this one here, it's got a soft edge, which might be nice. And I'm just going to change the size. Okay, and then I can just paint. Now, I've made the tone too bright, too light. Let me just go over here and I'll mix this to multiply. It's not bad. It's perhaps a little bit bright, but it's giving me some shadow, isn't it? So that's one way to work, is I'm just now painting with my brush. I've got a nice light tone. It's not it's not too distracting. It's just adding a little bit of tone here. Okay, and I can sort of play with it. Maybe use a warm up. Okay, and all that's looking pretty good. And if I make a mistake, remember this is all on a separate layer, and I could erase it, so I can get the E for eraser. And that works in a similar way to a brush. I can just erase some of the lines I've put down. I can even change the opacity up here. So that's 100% opacity. Or I could make it erase 50%. So it's just going to take a little bit off. Or I can take a lot off. So here I'm sort of erasing some of the grey just to add a few highlights and effects. And if I wanted to add another tone to this, but maybe darker, I could do a new layer. So I'll do a new layer and I'll call this tone dark, maybe. And I'm going to mix a new colour now. And I'm still on the same layer, and I'm going to hit the brush and I'm going to start painting. Now, what you'll notice here, because it's a bit darker, you can see that it's really kind of covering the line work. So this is where you want to use the multiply mode. So go up here to multiply. And now you can see that looks better, I reckon. Okay, now if it's starting to get a bit messy, or if you'd like to have neater edges, you can just change the way you apply the tone. For example, I could make a little shape using, there's a tool here called the lasso tool, and that's just a way to make a shape. So I'm kind of drawing it. Right, let's say like that. I'll do it a bit roughly. Now there it is. And now I'm going to fill that shape, edit, fill, with the foreground color, that gray color that I just had. All right. And that way it's kind of applied quickly. And if I want to get rid of some of that, I can just hit the eraser tool. I can erase some of it. Now I'm going to get rid of that wobbly line now. That's my selection line. So go to select and hit deselect. And you can see it's sitting there quite comfortably. And if I wanted to add more of that grey, I just hit the brush tool and zoom in a bit maybe and just brush in some more down here. Now, if I wanted to make it neater. Okay, or I could erase a little bit of that. Go to the eraser tool and hit maybe 50% or something. Make the brush larger and just erase some of that. So then you've kind of got a variety of tones. See that? So it starts to add a little bit of punch. Another way to apply tone is to draw a really clean shape. Okay, and there's a number of tools you can use for that. You can actually use this rectangular tool up here. So if I want to create a rectangle, I just click and drag like that. And then I can fill it with that same method that I mentioned before, edit fill. And if I'm not exactly happy, I can move the rectangle a little bit, some more, and then I can even delete some, right? So I can use another rectangle and I can hit delete, and that's deleting some of that gray. All right, that's one way, okay. The other way to do it is to draw a shape with a pen tool. Now this is a bit trickier, but go up here to the lasso tool and you hit this one. It's like a geometric, it's called a polygonal. And this draws sort of straight lines. So I could draw a set of straight lines, make a nice shape, and then fill it with the gray. Okay. Or I could leave it selected like that, get my brush tool out, and paint inside it. And I could even make that a little bit darker if I wanted. So by creating a shape with the lasso tool, you're given the opportunity then to maybe just brush inside it. All right, so if you want, you can add tone fairly carefully like that. All right, there you go. So save. I'll just show you a quick example here where I might add some for dramatic effect. I would probably draw some lines here just to help me sort of get the edge there a little bit. But it doesn't have to be perfect. So I could do it like that and I get my brush, mix my tone. I'll put this on a new layer. I'll just call this face. It's always good to have different layers, right? Enlarge the brush, and then I'm just going to paint. Okay, and then make the brush smaller, paint a little bit more carefully in there. Okay, and then I'm going to change the blending mode to multiply. Go up to select, deselect. You can see how it's starting to kind of add some drama. I could erase some of that. All right. And then hit the brush again. If I wanted, I could just fill some in here. Sort of painting into the shapes of his expression a bit. And then I could maybe darken this side a little bit more because it's sort of not that important. And maybe a little bit over here. So I'm just trying to build the tone a bit. All right, and that's starting to do it pretty quickly, as you can see. Okay, so we're back now after a little break, and I'm going to continue my little demonstration of using Photoshop to add tone, and we'll also try some color as well. So far what I've been doing is being sure to keep everything on a separate layer, as over here you can see in my layers panel. That's this panel up the top. Okay, if I go to another one, right, that's the layers panel. And the workspace that you open when you open Photoshop, if it looks different to mine, you just go up here to the top right and you can set different ones, right? This mine, I think, is based on essentials. You see that? It's very similar. And what this is doing is it's just bringing different tools to the foreground. So essentials is approximately the one I'm using. And when I need more tools, right? For example, here you can see I've got a few other tools open, but you can add them at any time. For example, if I want the info panel, I go up to window, I go down to info, and there it is. And then I can just click and drag it sort of into here, and then it stays there. right? So that's a way to get tools open. But you'll mainly use the layers panel here and the little tools on the left. And with my one, I had it separated into two columns because I quite like how that sits. And that's just this top key up here. All right. Just remember when you're working in Photoshop, it's a good idea to keep saving. So file, save, right, is the long way to do it, or Command S, which I just do all the time, Command S with my fingers. Okay, so if I wanted to keep going, like for example, let's now look at this bottom drawing here. What I could do, in fact, I'm going to do a new layer. I'm going to call it frame or large frame or something, just so I've got a few labels. And in this one, I'm going to draw some guidelines. So I'm going to turn on my rulers, which is view rulers. And then I'm going to drag down a couple of, I'm just clicking inside that area and dragging down couple of rulers, and this is just going to help me sort of see how my drawing is sitting and whether or not I need to rotate it. It's pretty good. Even if I check my verticals here, right, it's all pretty vertical. It's just slightly rotated maybe, but I'll tell you what, let's imagine I did need to rotate it. Let me show you how to do that. To do that, you go to the crop tool, which is up here. And then I can zoom out a little bit. Command minus is a quick way to zoom out. And then when I put my cursor up on the side in the corner, you'll see it go to a curvy shape. I put it over here even, the curvy shape. And then when I click and drag, it's actually rotating the drawing, see that? So what I could do is rotate it a little bit so I'm happier. Maybe there. And when I do that, I want to make sure I don't clip any of my drawings. So I'll just enlarge that a little bit. And then up here, hit the tick. Okay, so I just rotated it slightly, and now I think my lines might be slightly better. Not really, to be honest, they're almost worse. I might have a little bit of distortion in my drawing. So what I could do actually is just, I've just distorted a little bit. So I can see, if I look down the bottom drawing, I feel like that's a little bit short here on the left. So what I'm going to do, I'll show you how to distort it. it's a little bit late though, because I've already added some layers, but I'll do it anyway. So I'm going to go click on the line work layer. I'm going to go up to Edit, Transform, Perspective. And I'm just going to pull down that bottom left corner a little bit. And maybe pull up the top left a little bit. And that's kind of stretched it out a bit on the left. Hit okay. Now, you can probably see that it would have affected, see here the tires in a slightly different position, but it's not that big of a deal. I could just add to that, I could fix that. So go back in here and I'm going to mix a similar color to what I had. And the one way to do that is I can be in the brush tool. And if I hold down the option tool and click on that gray area, it'll sample the same color. So now I've got that same color. And as long as the opacity is set to 100, I can sort of fill that area in a bit. So if I feel like I've stuffed it up, I can sort of come back and fix it. So there's, you know, Photoshop's pretty great. As long as you keep the layers separate, you know, keep them built on separate layers, you can normally go back in and adjust almost everything. All right, so Command S for save. Now I've lost a little bit of information in here, but I'm not going to worry about that. So with my guidelines now that I'm happy, what I could do is I could add a kind of a box to the bottom one. So let's go back now to Frame Large, and I'm going to grab the rectangular marquee tool, this one up here, and I'm going to click and drag it into a nice big rectangle. All right, and it's on its own layer, so it's safe. And I'm going to fill this firstly by mixing a nice light tint, like maybe about there. I'm just going to try to pop things a bit. So, in fact, if I mix it about there, so it's a fairly darkish grey, medium grey, right? So that box is still selected. I'm going to File, Edit, Fill, Foreground Color. Boom. Okay, so don't panic. Remember, we can multiply. Okay, so now I've got a kind of a nice box, right, that's sort of filling everything. Right, and if I deselect that and just hide my rulers for a second. Right, you can see it's too much, right? But it's a starting point. It's almost like as a background tone. What I could do now is I could erase some of those areas. So by going to my eraser tool, I can now sort of bring back some of the skin tones, for example. Right, so I could do it that way. And, you know, depending on the style you're going for, this doesn't have to be perfectly neat, right? I can do this in a number of different ways. All right, so I could sort of bring up his car. If I want to brighten it up more, I just hit increase the opacity. So I'm now erasing more, so to speak, right? If I change the size of the brush, I can sort of get it working as a bit like a highlight. And at the moment, because it's on its own layer, it's going to be easy to sort of play with. Okay, so what else? That's all pretty good. All right, now if it's too much, I could reduce the opacity and just do it lightly. You know, maybe I just want to sort of lift some of these elements in the drawing. Now, you can actually do straight lines with the brush by holding down the shift key. So let me show you in a minute. Let's do a bit more of this random brushwork. If I wanted to do some straight lines, let's make the brush smaller. Okay, I could do a straight line from there, hold down the shift key, boom. So click a line, hold down the shift key, click, hold down the shift key. So those lines are kind of being drawn by the use of the shift key, if that makes sense. Changing the opacity again, this time to about 50%. So I'm still erasing, but I'm erasing 50%. So it's not the whole thing. Enlarge the brush a little bit. Okay, I mean, I could really have some fun here. What else? And you know, if I go too far, I can just brush it back in. So let's say I go too far. Let's say I want to get this brush off here. So I'm going to my brush tool. It hold down the option key, sample it from there, and then I can sort of brush it back in. Yeah, if I wanted to. Okay, it looks a bit messy, but that's okay. So the point is you can just kind of keep playing with this. So that's, I think, got a lot more drama to it now just because of that little bit of tone. And I could do another layer over here and brush, and I could sort of build on it more. So I could grab this darker tone, make it even a little bit darker again, and set it to multiply, and I can add some more. Again, just sort of pushing the kind of effect, I suppose, further. This guy's hair is probably quite dark, I think, on this guy, so. Or, you know, if I wanted, I could do the lasso tool. Remember? Okay, and I could draw a shape. And just kind of fill that shape. Okay, and again, where there's too much, hit the eraser tool, work back over it. And if I need more, hit the brush tool, sample the color. So you have all this control, it's really great. Oh, and this is all being done with a mouse. It's not very detailed control, but it has a good effect, I think. It's kind of cool. Yeah, I could add some tone down here. Sometimes better to not try to be very precise, because if I'm too precise, it gets messy like that. I just go get it all out. Mix a new color. Okay, and then just sort of paint it in. It's pretty good. If I go too far, let me go too far here. Right, then I could make another shape and just hit delete. All right, so anyway, that's, you know, if you did want to play with tone, Photoshop's really good. All of that, if I turn off those other layers, right, there's my original layer, still safe and sound, sitting over here. And then individually, I've built all these different layers. And if you find one's too much, like I could go to this one here and just reduce the opacity. Just knock it back so it's not too intense. Or I could reduce this one. Or if I wanted to intensify it, I could copy it, and that's sort of doubling it. So there's all these options for you folks. You know, if this was being fairly realistic, I'd probably have a sort of a really dark gray for the ground, as if it's an actual, tarmac, you know, or bitumen. Bitumen's the word. Something like this. Da, 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 da. that. I made a mistake here somewhere, but let's say it's that, and I could fill that with a darker gray, and then again erase what I don't want. But I really should undo that because that's on the wrong layer. Let's put it on its own layer and fill that, and then erase, turn it to multiply, and then erase what I don't need. Select, sample that, add a little bit more in there. And again, if I go too far, I can erase it. Even erase just bits of it so it's sort of softened it. Stuff like that. You know, just play. Just get the hang of it, you can just play. Good. Now I do want to separate these two. So what I might try there is a new layer. And I'll just draw a box around this top one. Maybe line it up with the other edges. And just put a little tint into it. Not too strong. Blend mode to multiply, fill. Okay, and again, you know, I could knock back some of that as needed. As fine, you know, stuff like that. Can you rough the edge up maybe? They're probably driving black cars, aren't they? You know. And you know, that's starting to look pretty good. Sort of the drawings have kind of got a bit of a separation to them, which is nice. I could clean up these lines here with a bit of what I could do is put a new layer on top and just fill that layer with white now. If I make a not fill the layer, but fill the shape. So if I make a shape here, and I could fill that with kind of a white color. And that's going to kind of neaten everything up, isn't it? Do the same up the side here. And then down the bottom. Side. made. So this is just, again, another layer sitting on top. So it's not damaging anything. And then maybe one down the middle there to separate. So, oh, and then one across here. Now this is where there's two drawings, so I really should just try to separate them, right? Right. And then I've gone a little bit fast, so get the eraser tool out. And that way I'm kind of separating the two drawings, I think. All right, so we're starting to get somewhere really with not too much effort. And as I say, it's completely adjustable. It's all there in different layers. Okay, and then when you're ready, you can just save it as it is, or you could save it as a what's called a compressed file. This has currently got many layers. You can see the layers, but you could do a save as, or save a copy, and then you could call the copy a JPEG, and that's going to be a much smaller file. Can even compress it down. So if I go and show you, if I open that JPEG now next to it, this one is, how big is it, Shane? This is 1.5 megs, that one. And the PSD, so this is the JPEG, right? It looks exactly the same, doesn't it? But it's actually much smaller. That's the JPEG, that's the PSD, and this is 128 megabytes, whereas this one is 1.5 megabytes. So by copying it, so I don't lose the original, but then saving it as a smaller JPEG, it's an easier file to share. All right, that's pretty good. I think what I'll do now is I'll just talk to you about color, right? The possibility of using color. So, I'm going to see if I can firstly find another sketch, because I've already got it scanned and it's just going to save me a little bit of time. I believe I've got it here somewhere, so let me just look. Spinning Wheel of Death. Okay, so should have, if I look at this according to date added, there we go. This is 2021. Okay, I've got to try to find where I put it. It must be in here, I think. Don't know. Here we go. Okay, so there he is there. So let's use this guy as an example. I'm going to grab the PSD file, which is the layered file, and open that up. So because I've kept it as a layered file, I can now go back to it 6 months later and play with it. So let's do that. Let's change this now to a colored image. So let's go File, Save a Copy. And I'll call this one Color in the same folder. So it's currently looking exactly the same. If we go up to Image and read the mode, you can see it's a grayscale. But I can change it to an RGB or a CMYK. I'll use RGB because this is mainly for the screen. RGB is the color space for the screen. And if I hit Don't Merge, if I hit Merge, it's going to flatten it all, but I don't want to do that. So I'm going to hit Don't Merge. So it's going to keep all the separate layers, but now they're in fact, it's a color file. So what I could do then, I could either change those colors individually or add new ones. Firstly, let me just show you how to change the colors. So when we've got an existing shape in a layer, like here's the shirt, right? What I can do is I can just change its color. And the simplest way to do it is select the layer and add a solid, I think that's what it is, solid color overlay. Right? Now, let's say we want him to have a red shirt. You pick the color, hit OK. Okay, but we want to confine that to this black shape. And the way to do that is to clip this layer's effect, which is making everything red, to just the black parts. And to do that, you right-click and you do create clipping mask. So it's clipped that red effect to the black layer underneath it. See that? If I just turn that off and see what it's doing. All right, now if I wanted it to apply it to his hair as well, I'd have to copy this layer. So click and drag it down to the copy, and then put that down here. And now clip it, right click, create clipping mask to the hair. But this up here, I've done that wrong. Right click there, create clipping mask. Oops. There we go. All right, but I don't like the red hair, so let's change the hair color. You could make it green if you want. You can make it any color. You just open this up and mix a color. You know, it could be a really dark kind of blondie color. Blondie brown color. All right. What if we wanted to give him a skin color? Well, we've got down here some shapes, some shadow shapes, but we don't have a whole overall skin area. So we could just paint that in. So let's create a new layer. Where is my base layer? Oh, it's on top. So I'll create a new layer. Click down here, new layer. And I'll mix a color, double click, mix a nice skin color. You know, it could be a kind of a pinky color. It's giving me kind of a pinky, classic pink skin color for a Western man. This is probably unrealistic, but let's try it. And I'm going to paint it over the top. Now remember, when I do this, sorry, I was in the erase tool, go to the brush tool. When I do this, it's going to paint it wildly over the top, right? Remember, we can erase it later. So I'm just going to kind of fill his skin areas pretty roughly. Maybe I'll leave his eyes. Make the brush bigger. That's a strange color. It's probably going to look really bad, but we'll just keep going. There's a, you can change the size of your brush, by the way. It's a shortcut I use all the time. It's the square bracket keys on your keyboard. The left square bracket key makes it smaller, and the right square bracket key makes it larger. Anyway, so there's the skin, right? Now, if I mix that to a multiply, you can see it's kind of mixing in pretty well. I really don't like the color, but you know, it's kind of interesting, I suppose. What if we put another color behind him? What if we put another color in here? Let me draw the M tool, drawing a box. I'm going to put that underneath, on a new layer underneath the skin color. I'm going to fill that with a bluish color. Okay, and I'm going to fill it, right? But I want to put, you know, it behind him. So I'm going to bring the pen above, the ink line above, and I want to sort of erase this. So if I put that above there, what I'm actually going to, in fact, you know what? That kind of looks cool because the skin color's changed from a pink to a blue pink. But I could erase the pink from the blue. And what you would do that is select the skin layer, right? This is the skin. Hold down Command and click on the thumbnail. And that's going to select the skin area. Okay, it's selecting everything that's in that thumbnail. And then by clicking or selecting on the blue color, I can now hit erase. And it's cut the skin shape out of the blue area. Pretty good, right? Deselect. And if I wanted to bring that hair on top, I can do that. I really don't like that hair color. All right, and you know, I could keep going now. I could add another layer for more hair color. I could grab that hair color sample by hitting Alt key or the Option key, but just hit about a 50%. And now here, I could fill it in those areas, just in those areas. And I'll just try to keep it off of his skin. But if I miss it, I can just erase, and I'll hit erase. So this is sort of like his hair color, but not quite for the strength. All right, and where I've made a mistake, go to the erase tool and just erase the bits I don't like. All right. Now I could add a little bit of eye color, hit a new layer, zoom in. I could just use a brush for this, mix a new color. Let's mix a nice blue eye color. Okay, again, I've gone too far. Multiply and then erase. It's you know, you can play like that, right? So, you know, not bad. You can really have some fun. And, you know, if I had have done this, see, at the moment, this layer here has got all the background on it. See how the black line has also got the paper? But I could get rid of that. So let me copy that first, and I'll turn off the copy and put it down the bottom. So it's just kind of safe. Oh, there's already one there. Okay, good. So what I'm going to do with this layer is I'm going to erase the background. So I select the layer, and I go over to here to the erase tool and hit Magic Eraser. And if I click now in the background, it's going to erase everything that it thinks is the paper, or I could even get it to get rid of the pencil line if I'm careful, but that might be too hard. So I'll go back to the normal eraser now, and I'll use the normal eraser to get rid of the pencil. But I don't want that line either. So I'm just erasing all of these background elements. So that the overall drawing is much cleaner. Remember, there was even pencil lines on his face. I'm just kind of getting rid of those as well. Careful, you don't want to get rid of the nice line work. All right, and then when I turn on the other layers again, you can see it looks cleaner, I think, than it was, than it did. All right, and, you know, then I could go further. I could add a little bit more here. Just grab that color and just paint it up in there maybe. Just getting rid of some of that so I can add some more here. Okay, and that's the way you build your drawing, potentially. One of the ways, anyway. All right. That might be enough for now, I think. Don't forget to hit save. Look, one small thing. I'm just noticing that line is so harsh, the shadow area. I'd just like to soften it, so I'm going to find that layer, that's this one. I'm going to get my eraser tool, and I'm going to set it to about 50%. And what that's going to do is just going to allow me to kind of soften, so it's not such a hard shadow, which I think will look a little bit more natural. Because shadows are normally never really hard-edged. They're normally a little soft, the softness to them. Normally. I think that looks better. Yeah? It is important to keep saving, because if your computer slows down like this one is now, it might crash, so if you haven't saved it, you might be disappointed. Anyway, there you go, guys. I'll stop the tutorial there, I think.